Toastmaster. And thank you indeed, Fauntleroy Community Association, for inviting me here this evening to talk about something we don't want to talk about, paid parking. I'm going to start by talking about a scenario, giving a scenario that I think most of us will have experienced. You're in a rush. You ride into Admiral Junction, and you can't find a place to park. All you had to do was go to a store and pick something up and tear off again. What do? You might think of driving around, circling a block. You realize that is going to take me 5 minutes, at least. 5 minutes to go to the store. Before you know it, 15 minutes are gone. You decide to forego the stop. The conclusion of the scenario, what it has done, is produced a lose-lose situation. You lose because you didn't pick up that item. You're at least frustrated. And the store owner loses because they lose that sale. The solution to this is on-street paid parking. I'm going to give a few more pros and cons and a few statistics about it, and hope at the end of this evening you're going to say at least break as an argument for paid parking. Parking actually is a contentious issue for many, many cities. We're a country that has vast regions and places people drive. You go from A to B, and when you get to B, you want to park. The last thing you want to do is get frustrated and run around trying to find a place to park. Interesting enough, this dilemma has been around for a long time. In fact, in the horse and buggy stage, they had the same problem. That time, they solved the problem by hanging. But fortunately, we're not going to talk about that. However, we have to look at paid parking as being a fair, equitable solution. Consider you have a car. And the words of Donald Shoup, an economist, he said, you pay for the car, you pay for the gas, you pay for the tires, you pay for the insurance. Why should you not pay for parking as well? Some people say the argument against that is that it's a public good. And as a public good, it should be free. The problem is that parking is finite. Once a car is in that spot, nobody else can use it. We say, well, the roads are free. No, they are not. We have gas tax. Pretty soon we're going to have a tax on the viaduct replacement thing out there. That argument, as far as I'm concerned, does not hold water. People go on then and say, well, break, it's a regressive tax because it disproportionately uses poor people's income to pay for parking. Fact is that by far the majority who don't own cars are the poor. Additionally, parking spaces alone to construct them cost around $1,700 a spot, and believe it or not, $400 a year of maintenance. And that is a much more direct tax to them because they pay for it when they buy their goods and services just to live. And don't get me wrong, I too love to find free parking. I will indeed circle the block. I will try to park two blocks away. However, I have another confession to make. I am a frequenter of Post Toasties. And I noticed that when I started quite recently going to Post Toasties is that there were absolutely no spots at all park in the Admiral Junction. And they got me thinking about, well, how do we solve this problem? Well, we solve this problem by introducing on-street paid parking. People like me would win because there'd be undoubtedly a spot there available. Because when you introduce on-street paid parking, you adjust the price of the parking so that on average there are 1 to 2 spots always available. And in fact, you might say, well, okay, fine, I'll give in, right, we'll go for on-street paid parking. How do you set the price, though? The city of San Francisco actually recently came up with an idea. They monitored the price of the meters in one zone, and they determined that if they hit a sweet spot of a price, there were always going to be 1 to 2 spots always available. In addition, interesting as well, they noticed that there were 30% less cars cruising around, because I think people realized, well, this is going to be the price here. I know I can find a spot or not. Merchants win in a case like that as well. When you have traffic continuously moving, people coming and going, that is when there are things that are spot. If you do not have paid parking, and you just have on-street parking, cars will stay there forever. Yes, that one car might make a purchase, but then that's it for the evening. But if you do have a constant circulation of cars, you get a constant improvement in the economy of that particular locale. And also, if you do have that one purchase to make in a hurry, you do have a likely chance of finding a place to park and get in there and get out. That is turning my original lose-lose scenario into a win. I'm talking about a fair system of parking for everybody. User pay system where you have an opportunity to find a place to park, to shop, and maybe myself, I'll find a place